In this Track and Trade Seasonals educational video, we're going to learn how to integrate the seasonal nature of markets into our daily trading strategy. The first thing we want to remember is the saying, never buck the seasonal trend. Determining the overall trend of a market is key to our trading. We always want to be aware of the trend, not only the short-term trend, but the long-term trend as well as the seasonal trend. Remember, the trend is your friend until it bends or ends. We analyze the seasonal trend in two ways, the long-term trend, 5, 10, or 15-year average, which is displayed in the lower indicator window, and the short-term price averages, 3 to 5 years, or even shorter, which we lay directly over the chart. Notice in this example, we're looking at the seasonal price averages laid directly over the top of our current price chart. The seasonal nature of markets can be determined on a long-term basis or a short-term basis. But of course, the more data and the more recent the data, the more reliable our data model. The most recent data is the most important, and that's why we'll oftentimes weight the averages toward the more recent years. Let's take a look at several examples of historical price averages predicting future price action within several different individual commodities. Notice how current market prices correspond to the seasonal indicator, and how market prices seem to follow the seasonal trend, which is projected out into the future. For example, on this chart, I have my averages set to 1 and 3. By setting the first moving average to 1, all I'm doing is asking Track and Trade to simply display last year's prices over this year's chart. I like this view, since it shows me the difference between this year and last year. I then set my other line to calculate the 3-year price average, which provides a more general trend of price over the past 3 years. I can use these two lines to help me make a determination of where prices might be headed next. If we then slide down to take a look at the lower window, we see that the long-term historical trend indicator is displaying strong peaks and valleys. It's these price extremes that we want to watch for and possibly trade. Notice that the lower seasonal trend indicator is not a reflection of actual market prices, but a trend indicator only. Being set to a 0 to 100 scale allows us to see the price extremes in a more dramatic fashion, allowing us to more easily identify seasonal price action. Here's an example of a strong seasonal trend in corn. Here's an example of a strong seasonal trend in gold. And here's an example of a strong seasonal trend in wheat. Again, it's not only traditional commodities that reveal seasonal trends. Other markets have factors that cause seasonal price cycle extremes at the same time each year as well. Here's an example of a currency, Canadian dollar. And here's an example of the 10-year T-note, which is basically an interest rate bond. It too has experienced a very strong historical seasonal cycle and trend. You'll very often see current market prices follow these historical price averages almost like a train on rails. Now, we all know that past price performance is not necessarily indicative of what prices might do today, but in my experience, it gives us a great window into what we can expect, so long as we're experiencing what we call a normal year. A normal year is a year where we're not experiencing any unforeseen outside forces that might change the seasonal trend. Things seem normal from the perspective of the current market. If we do experience some sort of outside force that changes the normal seasonal cycle, this generally results in the anticipated seasonal trend to move dramatically in the opposite direction. We then call this a counter-seasonal trend. A failed pattern can oftentimes be the most powerful indicator of all, and that goes for seasonal patterns as well. Counter-seasonal trends, although hard to deduce in the beginning, oftentimes end up being extreme price moves in the exact opposite direction of what we anticipated. Here's an example of a counter-seasonal trend. Notice that the price chart moves in almost the exact opposite direction of the historical averages. Here's another example. Again, see how the market moved in the exact opposite direction at almost the exact start time of our anticipated seasonal price cycle. To catch these counter-seasonal trends, keep a close watch on your technical indicators, as they will be the first indication that that market is not performing as anticipated. Of course, always stay tuned to the current fundamental news of the market, making sure you're always aware of any news events that could affect your trade as well. I'll go ahead and make a shameless plug right here for another software program we call NewsMiner, which was designed exactly for this purpose. to help you keep up on the current market news that can affect your active trading positions. You can find NewsMiner on the web at www.newsminer.info. Okay, that said, we never want to base our entire trading strategy off of the seasonal trend averages exclusively, or off of the technical indicator exclusively for that matter. As traders, we know that the fundamental nature of markets drive the long-term trends, and it's the long-term trends that we most want to trade. But timing is everything. Knowing when to enter a market is best done through the use of technical indicators, tools that mathematically measure the current market trends and provide buy and sell signals at change points. It's when we use these two tools, technical and fundamental, one in combination with the other, that we get what I like to call the 1-2-3 knockout punch. How we do this is we find a market that has experienced a high number of price extremes at the same time each year, or close to it, for a number of years on end. The more the better. This is best done through the use of Gecko Software's TradeMiner software, or by simply watching the seasonal price chart within Track and Trade. Once we've identified the market we're interested in, we take a look at this year's current price action and see if it seems to be in line with our seasonal or fundamental expectations. If it is, we then turn our attention to the technical indicators. Of course, I like to watch the bulls and bears indicator, so we look for a technical signal from our bulls and bears at the point that we expect the seasonal trend to begin. Once we get the signal, there are a number of ways we can trade these patterns. First, we can simply jump in with a contract or two, or we could buy and sell option strategies designed to take advantage of these types of situations, or we could even consider setting up a spread and trading the spread. Many traders will use this as a trend indicator for day trading, only taking positions in the direction of the overall, longer-term, newly established seasonal trend. However you choose to trade the seasonal trend, always remember, the trend is your friend until it bends or ends. Markets move in waves, and even in a seasonal cycle, we experience advancing and declining markets. So always use caution and solid risk and money management strategies to protect your positions.